the new status of NITDroid. Say I'm running in the MMO at the minute. You can see, move that across a bit so you can actually see. Charger's plugged in and it's quite happy sitting charging in MMO. Should mention I'm actually using a little adapter charger you get, not the standard one. Just because my standard one's upstairs and I can't be bothered to dig it out. Same using a totally different boot menu and kernel what most people are using at the moment. I know I've not put up any videos recently, just because I've been busy with work and I did try to put one up the other week but it was too long. Takes a little while to load up. Now, anybody who's used a build of NITDroid will recognise that launcher is not the standard one for what you get for Android. I've added that because of one reason. It's much faster. Settings, go to wireless, see there I'm connected to Wi-Fi and if going here I don't know how you can see because of the light on the camera. But we have Bluetooth active as well. Back to the main screen, close it, disconnect the charger, which isn't going to work in Android anywhere. We do have battery charging, but it's only via the proper charger. If I rotate the phone around, it takes. The screen will happily rotate. We fixed the issue with battery, with CPU usage in that as well. If I go into display, brightness, can adjust the brightness and the contrast of the display. Turn it all the way up, but it makes it a bit easier to read. If I also go into SD and phone storage, yes, you can see I've got the we've got the mount of the memory card, internal memory going again. That was a pain. Also, just to check that is actually right, I'll go into the music application. Pick an album. Pick one from the top 40. It's an old one. We've also got some other things built onto this kernel, because it's a test kernel I'm using, I'm not using the standard one. You actually can get still the one we're using for testing. But the lock switch on the side. I don't know how well you can actually see that. Reboot, power off. We also have a different back button. If I close it, press the power button on the top. Takes you all the way back. Menu key has been remapped up here to the camera. Volume is still as normal. We will be using the proximity sensor for home. We just need to get some things finalised for that. The minute the keyboard settings are duplicated, we haven't got a backspace. We've got the arrow keys, but they're being fixed. It's not a major problem. Just a matter of playing with the key maps. That's all I wanted to show for today. The fact that we've got Google Apps running, we've got the memory card and music support now.